In this screencast, we have a cylindrical pure carbon rod. It has a length of 25 centimeters. You have an initial diameter of 2 centimeters, and we put it into a flowing airstream. This airstream is 1,000 Kelvin and 2 atmosphere pressure. And what happens is that the gas will create a steady state quiescent boundary layer. And this boundary layer will be 0.5 centimeters thick around the entire surface of the rod. So basically around here. Recall that this is cylindrical. And what happens is a reaction takes place where carbon is oxidized to carbon dioxide. This reaction is diffusion limited by the O2 that goes through the boundary layer from the quiescent air outside. The diffusion is only in the R direction. So basically, it goes in that direction. We have a concentration within the boundary layer of 2 times 10 to the minus 5th moles per centimeter cubed. And this diffusion coefficient is 0.7 centimeters squared per second. And outside the boundary layer, we have a bulk composition of the airstream. And the importance of that is we're looking at the oxygen, which means the mole fraction of oxygen outside that boundary layer is going to be 0.21. And what we want is the initial rate of CO2 production from the rod within this boundary layer. To solve the problem, we're going to have to use the fact that this rate of production is equal to the flux of A times the surface area. What we have to find is this flux of A. What equations do we use to find N sub A? Well, the first one is continuity, because in continuity, we find our N sub A as a function of R. After we've found that, we can insert it into the Fick's law equation to solve for our N sub A. So let's start with the continuity equation. This is the general continuity equation, and we can simplify it for our particular situation. So the problem states that it is at steady state, so there's no concentration with respect to time. It's only in the R direction. All we have to do is use the R component of this directional part of the continuity equation. And finally, there is no accumulation term within the boundary layer. So what we're left with is 1 over R ddr times R n sub A equals 0. And that's that R direction part of the term in the continuity equation. And we can simplify this even further. ddr of R n sub A equals 0. When we integrate it, we find that n sub A equals a constant divided by R. Now that we have our flux as a function of R, we insert it into the Fick's law equation. So let's see if we can simplify this equation. We have our concentration, our diffusion coefficient, and the change in the mole fraction of A, or oxygen, with respect to R. However, if we look at this term actually goes to 0. It's not the fact that Y sub A is 0, in other words, that it's dilute. The reason this term goes to 0 is that we have equal molar diffusion due to our reaction. And let's go back to our reaction here that says our O2 and our CO2 are the same number of moles. So that means that N sub A will equal negative N sub B, and that term does go to 0. So now What we're left with is N sub A equals minus C D sub A B D Y A D R. However, we can't initially integrate that because, as we saw before, N sub A is a function of R. However, if you look at this and rearrange it, what we find is this constant that I'll call C1 is equal to RNA. So if we can use this as a constant, we can then go back to our fixed law equation and write it this way. We multiply that first term by R divided by R, or 1, and what we're left with is RNA divided by R equals minus C D sub A B D Y A D R. And remembering that R N sub A is a constant, then we can write this as R N sub A, the integral from R1 to R2, dr over R, where we got that R up here, is going to equal the integral from 0, which is y sub a at R1, to 0.21, which is the y sub a, or the mole fraction of oxygen in the bulk. This is preceded by our concentration within the boundary layer, then minus C D sub A B D Y sub A. So now we have an integral on both sides that we can solve for. So when we do, we come out with R times this flux, the natural log of R2 divided by R1 equals minus concentration times the diffusion coefficient 0.21 minus 0. Let's use this and insert it into our original equation for our initial rate of CO2 production. In other words, that W. So this simplifies to minus C times the diffusion coefficient times 0.21, the natural log of R2 over R1 times 2 pi L. Let's put our numbers in that we were given in the problem so that we can solve for this initial rate of carbon dioxide production. Notice in the bottom that our R2 and R1 are based on 0 equaling the center of the carbon rod. We find that the rate of oxygen production is negative 1.14 times 10 to the minus 3 moles per second. But remember what we originally asked for, which is the rate of the carbon dioxide production. And if we go back here and look at our equation, what we find out here is that it's the same rate, only a different sign, which makes sense because we are producing CO2 at a rate of 1.14 times 10 to the minus 3 moles per second.